गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्रुण्वन्नुतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम्। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, इन् द लास्ट् क्लास् वि वर् सीङ्ग् दिस् श्लोक नम्बर् 23 आफ् 13th अध्याय, दट् ईस् दिस् श्लोक दट् ईस् य एवं वेत्ति पुरुषं प्रकृतिं प्रकृतिञ्च गुणैस्सह सर्वथा वर्तमानोऽपि न स भूयोऽभिजायते। So we read that whole shloka and then we were in the middle of the bhashyam. So the shloka is about a jnani who has attained this aparoksha atma sakshatkara. Jnani means, naturally a jnani means one who has attained this aparoksha sakshatkara, not merely a theoretical jnani, but who realizes himself as Brahman. So such a man, sarvatha vartamanopi, whether he follows the, say, the laid down rituals and all this, ashrama dharma. Ashrama dharma means there are certain duties which are laid down for every ashrama, for every varna, etc. Though he is not following any of these things, he is not doing any sort of dharma vyatikrama, and then he is sarvatha vartamanopi nasa bhuyobhi jayate. So it does not affect his jnana as such. So jnani is somebody who has risen above all these varna, ashrama, dharma. So that is how all his deeds, whatever past deeds, etc., all the deeds, they get burnt. Sarva karma dahaha. We stopped there at that word. So in the last class we read this line, tasya tavadeva chiram इषीकातूलवत्सर्वकर्माणि प्रदूयन्ते इत्यादि श्रुतेभ्यश्च श्रुतिशतेभ्यः उक्तः विदुषः सर्वकर्मदाहः। दाह मीन्स् बर्निङ्ग् अवे आल् दि एक्षन्स् आफ् दिस् आल् दि कर्मास् आल् दि सञ्चित कर्म द होल् बेगेज् आफ् कर्म विच् इस् देर् फार् द लास्ट् सेवरल् जन्मास् द होल् बेगेज् गेट्स् डेस्ट्राय्ड्। सो दट् इस् वाट् वि रेड्। So there is a debate about that, because the Purvapakshi is unable to accept this, because we have to realize that during that Shankaracharya's time, but prior to that, there was a lot of emphasis on karma. The human society, when we say human society, we refer to our Indian society, they were more interested in the karmas, the rituals, all these yajnas, yagas, the performance of rituals, and then they wanted to their idea was that ritual was something which is supreme, something which is just unavoidable, and there is nothing above that. So at that time, a sort of revival of Upanishadic philosophy was brought about by a small band of people like Govinda Bhagavatpada, and then it was probably prior to Govinda Bhagavatpada also, all the people must have been there. So that line was also there. And Shankara Bhagavatpada has given a very great, he has projected it properly, and then he has brought it out, and then he has focused on that particular thing and debated on that extensively, and then he has established a particular structure. So that is what is the overall background we have to note. So against that background, the Purvapakshi, that is Mimamsaka, their arguments have to be countered, and then all those arguments have to be discussed in the light of what the Upanishads say. Ultimately, the Upanishads are the final, Shruti is final. So, that discussion we are in now. So, we have to read the next line. Ihapicha uktaha. Yathaidhamsi ityadina. Sarvakarmadahaha. इहापिच इवन हियर उक्तः इट हैज बीन टोल्ड व्हाट यथाइधामसि समिद्धोग्निर् भस्मसात् कुरुते अर्जुन दैट इज फोर्थ अध्याय यथाइधामसि समिद्धोग्निः भस्मसात् कुरुते अर्जुन ओ अर्जुन जस्ट एज ए वेल लिट फायर समिद्धः अग्निः आयधा एधामसि भस्मसात् कुरुते जस्ट एज ए वेल लिट फायर विल टोटली बर्न अवे ऑल दिस स्टिक्स Yedhamsi means samidha. Samidha means all dry twigs which are put in the fire. So all those dry twigs and all that, they are just burnt away. by this well lit fire. So similarly, all the karmas, they get destroyed. So that is what that shloka says. So it has been told earlier. And Vakshyaticha, Vakshyaticha means he is also going to say, let us read it. Vakshyaticha,
Vakshyaticha,
Upapatteshcha,
Upapatteshcha,
Vakshyaticha means he is also going to say, where Anandagiri is pointing out, Sarvadharman Parityajya iti Vakya Sheshopi Pramani Bhavati. That is what Anandagiri is writing. To which shloka, exactly to which shloka it is referring means, it is referring to that Sarvadharman Parityajya Mamekam Saranam Raja. Aham Tvam Sarva Papebhyo Mokshayishyami Mashucha. So that line, 18th chapter, 66th shloka, he is referring. And then there, Aham Tva Sarva Papebhyo Mokshayishyami. So all the activities, Papebhyo means not merely papas, all the punyas also, all the activity, all the whole baggage of karma. The whole baggage of karma will be destroyed. So that is what Krishna says in that. There again, there is a long discussion. There is again a long discussion because the Mimamsaka predominance obviously was very much there in that Shankaracharya's time. So we know that Shankaracharya was mainly battling this Mimamsakas and to some extent Sankhyas, to some extent Buddhists. So these were the three dominant people say at that time. So he had to battle all these people. So here, Vakshyaticha, Vakshyati means he will say, he is going to say, then Upapatteshcha, and also by logic. What is that logic? We are going to see that logic. Upapatti means even by logic, even logically speaking, it has to be so. Then, Avidya Karma,
Avidya Karma,
Klesha Bija Nimittani hi Karmani,
Klesha Bija Nimittani hi Karmani,
Janmantarankuram Arabhante, Karmas, how are they caused, or how is a man getting into all those karmas? That is because of avidya. Avidya and also kama. Kama means desire. Avidya, karma. Avidya, kama also, of course, kama is not mentioned here. Avidya, kama. Next is karma. Avidya produces kama. Kama produces karma. All this is all klesha. Klesha is again a technical word. You can just switch it on. Klesha is again a technical word. That is, in Patanjali Yoga Sutra, there is a sutra. What are these kleshas? He mentions five kleshas. What are klesha means? Which are basically troubles. Which are basically troubles in the path of obstacles or troubles in the path of knowledge. What are they? Avidya, Asmita, Raga, Dvesha, Abhinivesha, Pancha Kleshaha. There is a sutra of Patanjali. Avidya, Asmita, avidya, we know ignorance. Asmita, asmita means the notion of I, asmi. Asmi is I am, that asmita is that notion of I-ness. So that is one, that ego, ahankara. Then raga, attachment. Dvesha, dvesha is hatred, dislike for a thing. Then abhinivesha, abhinivesha means clinging to an object, clinging. So clinging to something, that is what is abhinivesha. Avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha, pancha klesha, he says. So like that, they are the kleshas, they are the obstacles, klishyanti, that is they trouble a person. So that is why they are called kleshas. So these are these kleshas, klesha bija nimittani. All these things are, they form the seed, they form the seed for karma. Bija, bija means a seed. Bija nimittani hi karmani. And these are janmantarankuram arabhante. These karmas, because they are the seed, janmantarankuram arabhante. So they produce or they cause, they generate this janmantara ankuram. Ankuram means a sprout. Ankura is a sprout. You see, you sow a seed and after a few days you see a sprout. So that is called ankuram. Janmantara ankuram. A sprout called Janmantara is produced by these karmas. So that is the meaning. A sprout called Janmantara. Janmantara means another life. Another life is produced by this. Then Ihapicha. साहंकारा अभिसंधीनि कर्माणि दट वीड इट ओके इहापिच इवन हियर भगवता तत्र तत्र उक्तम तत्र तत्र मीन्स हियर एंड देयर इन दिस बुक आल्सो लॉर्ड कृष्णा हैज बीन सेइंग इट सो ही इज सेइंग दैट साहंकार अभिसंधीनि कर्माणि सो दिस कर्मास विच आर डन विद द सेंस ऑफ विद द नोशन ऑफ आई साहंकार साहंकार मीन्स सा प्लस अहंकार दट ईज असोसिएटेड विद आई नोशन associated with the notion of I, sahankara, then abhisandhi, abhisandhi means that clinging to that fruit of action, then such karmas, phala arambhakani, so they give the fruit, if you desire the fruit, fruit comes, if you don't desire the fruit doesn't come. In fact, one teacher, Mudigonda Venkatrama Shastri, one very old teacher, he has quoted a very beautiful, he quotes a very beautiful shloka from Mahabharata. That Mahabharata reference is dharmam dharmanubandhancha kama artham arthanubandhanam then kamam kamanubandhamcha. So it starts like that, the last line I don't remember. The overall meaning is told in the context of Sage Vyasa. You know the story of Sage Vyasa who say there are three sisters called Amba, Ambika and Ambalika. Amba goes away and marries somebody. Ambika and Ambalika, they marry that Vichitravirya and then they become widows. And then that Kuru Vamsha has to be sustained. So in olden days, there was a practice that a great Rishi had to be called. And that Rishi has to say sleep with them and then he has to produce children. You know this or not? You know, you don't know. Are, you please read Mahabharata. So, whenever the king suddenly dies, the queen doesn't have children. So, what to do? How to sustain the empire? So, they used to call some great sage and then that sage has to have intercourse with this lady and then he has to produce a child. So, that was what was done in the case of all these Dhritarashtra and all these people. They were born like that, to that Ambika and Ambalika. So, there this context comes. Dharmam dharmanubandham cha. Dharma which is performed with a clear notion that I am doing dharma, then that is something, it is just doesn't, when he clearly performs dharma for its own sake, then that is what is supreme. And it should not, kamam, kamanubandham is something different. Kama, kama means say physical desire, and then that desire, if you are pursuing it for the sake of kama, then it is bad. It is something which has to be denounced. But that kama, it becomes dharma when you are doing it for the sake of dharma. So there Sage Vyasa, though he slept with them, so he was doing it for the sake of dharma. So that is why he was not having any, he has not to be blamed. And then in that process, we should also remember that these people, they don't, it is not from the point of view of me, from the point of view of sex it has to be done. This man has to apply some dark, say, paint all over the body and he should appear as ugly as possible. The person who goes, he should appear as ugly as possible. And then in that condition, without any sense of kama, without any sense of lust, without any notion of lust, he has to perform that act. And that is how the child has to be produced. So that was, anyway, this is something, this is a sloka which was quoted by that Venkatrama Shastri, suddenly I recalled it. That is, dharmam dharmanubandham cha, kamam kamanubandhanam. So dharma, this kama, when it is done from the point of view of dharma, it does not become kama. So that is it. So like that, phalabhi sahankara abhisandhini karmani phalarambhakani. So when you have that notion of I-ness, then only they produce results, not otherwise. Iti na itarani, not other, not the other type of say karmas, that is as in the case of a karma yogi who performs karmas. So what Vyasa sage Vyasa was doing there was a karma yoga only. So anyway, of course we can't bring down Vyasa to that level because Vyasa was a jnani. Vyasa was a, we can't bring him down to the level of a karma yogi. So next line.
बीजानि अग्न्युपदग्धानि
न रोहन्ति यथा पुनः ज्ञानदग्धैस्तथा क्लेशैः नात्मा संपद्यते पुनः इति च ओके देयर इज अ श्लोक फ्रॉम वनपर्व वनपर्व मीन्स वेयर ऑल दीज पांडवर्स दे गो टू द फॉरेस्ट एंड देन दे स्पेंड देयर दैट फॉरेस्ट टेन्योर सो इन दैट पर्व देयर इज अ श्लोक बीजानि अग्न्युपदग्धानि सो यू टेक सम सीड्स बीजानि यू टेक सम सीड्स एंड देन यू बर्न देम Once you roast them, they don't again sprout. Agni upadagdhani, roasted seeds, let us say. That roasted seeds, na rohanti, na prarohanti, they don't sprout. Na yatha punaha, just as they do not sprout again, then similarly, jnanadagdhais tatha kleshaihi. So by these kleshas, avidya, smita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha, all these kleshas, when they are burnt away by this jnana, they don't again sprout. ज्ञानदग्धैः तथा क्लेशैः न आत्मा संपद्यते पुनः दिस बीइंग अगेन विल नॉट कम इन टू एक्जिस्टेंस इन द सेंस ही विल नॉट बी बॉर्न अगेन न आत्मा संपद्यते पुनः मीन्स ही विल नॉट बी बॉर्न अगेन इति च देन अगेन देयर इज अ पूर्वपक्षी इज अगेन ऑब्जेक्टिंग ओके आई अग्री दैट व्हाट द पूर्वपक्षी इज सेइंग इज ओके आई अग्री दैट से व्हेन ए पर्सन ए ज्ञानी डज समथिंग Then some action, Jnani performs some action and then that action will not give result. I agree to that. Then what about the actions done in this life before he became a Jnani? So that is one point he raises. And what about the activities of previous Janmas? There are three types of Janmas which were discussed earlier. Three types of karmas. So he is talking about those karmas. I agree that, okay, whatever a Jnani does after he becomes a Jnani, I agree that they will not give a result. But what about the karmas done earlier in this life and karmas done in earlier lives? So that is the Purvapaksha. Astu tavat.
Jnanotpatyuttarakala krutanam.
Karmanam jnanena dahaha. Jnana sahabhavitvat. Astu tavat means, okay, I agree with you that ज्ञानोत्पत्ति उत्तरकाल कृतानां कर्मणां दैट इज दीज कर्मास विच हैव बीन परफॉर्म्ड बाय दिस जेंटलमैन आफ्टर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति दैट इज आफ्टर ही बिकेम आफ्टर ही हैड द रियलाइजेशन देन फॉर दैट ज्ञानेन दाहः ज्ञान सहभावित्वात् बिकॉज ही इट इज असोसिएटेड विद ज्ञानम ही इज ए ज्ञानी एंड दैट ज्ञानम डज नॉट डिसअपियर दैट अवेयरनेस डज नॉट डिसअपियर So in that state of awareness, he has performed some action. So we agree that those karmas will not give result. Then, natu iha janmani jnanotpatteh prak krutanam. Atita aneka janmantara krutanam cha dahaha yuktaha. This is the point. Natu iha, but on the other hand, but not in the case of इह जन्मनि ज्ञानोत्पत्तेः प्राक् मीन्स् प्रायर् टु दिस् ज्ञानोत्पत्ति बिफोर् दिस् मेन् रियलैज्ड् हिस् सेल्फ् कृतानां कर्मणां फार् आल् दोस् कर्मास् विच् आर् पर्फार्म्ड् अट् दट् स्टेज् एण्ड् देन् अतीत अनेकजन्मान्तरकृतानां इन् द प्रीवियस् बर्त्स् इन् द प्रीवियस् सेवरल् अतीत अनेकजन्मान्तर दट् ईस् इन् द प्रीवियस् सेवरल् बर्त्स् In all those karmas, he has performed lot many, in all those janmas, he has performed lot many activities, lot many karmas. What about all of them? That's what he says. For all of them, dahaha na yuktaha. Dahaha means burning away. It is not proper. So then, the Siddhanti says, na. Sarva karmani iti visheshanat. It is not so. Jnanagni dagdha karmani. Sarva karmani iti visheshanam. It is seen... of course, in this shloka it is not there. Sarva karmani. It is there in several shlokas. Sarva karmani.
Ishikatulavat sarvani karmani.
So, sarvani karmani that has been told very, very specifically. Ishikatulavat sarvaya. So, like that, it is told several in several places. And you can't say that there is something which is special. There is no reason to restrict the meaning of that sarva karma. To the karmas which are performed only after the realization. Karmas performed after realization, you are trying to restrict the meaning of sarva karmani only to refer to this. We don't see any reason to restrict the meaning. So that is what he is going to say. Where is this? Sarva karmani iti visheshanat. Okay. ज्ञानोत्तर काल भाविनामेव सर्वकर्माणि इति चेत् न संकोचत्वे कारण अनुपपत्तेः ओके इफ यू से दैट ज्ञानोत्तर काल भाविनामेव सर्वकर्मणां व्हेन यू से ऑल कर्मास ज्ञानोत्पत्ति ज्ञानोत्तर काल भावी दैट इज ऑल द कर्मास विच वर ऑल द कर्मास दैट ऑल इज द इनवर्टेड कमास सो दैट इनवर्टेड कमास ऑल All means the Purvapakshi is saying all karmas which are done after Jnanotpatti. Whereas Siddhanti says all refers to all karmas done earlier in this life and also in previous janmas. So that is what is the meaning of all. So that is the point here. Jnanottara kala bhavitvena sarva karmanam iti chet na. No, you can't say that. Sankochatve. Sankocha means to restrict. Sankocha, vyakocha, we know these words. Sankocha means diminishing in size. Vyakocha means expansion. Expansion and contraction, let us say. Contraction, you know. Contraction means the meaning gets contracted, restricted. Sankocha. Vyakocha. Iron rod, it expands when it is heated. So that is what we have seen in elementary physics. So something like that. So vyakocha is expansion. Sankocha is contraction. So sankochatve, for the restriction of meaning, karana anupapattehe, there is no reason. There is no reason why you have to restrict the meaning only to the karmas done in this, jnanotpatti anantaram. then he comes to another point. Yattu uktam.
Yatha vartamana janmantararambhakani.
कर्माणि न क्षीयन्ते फलदानाय प्रवृत्तान्येव सत्यपि ज्ञाने तथा अनारब्ध फलानामपि कर्मणां क्षयो न युक्तः इति So he is reiterating the Purvapaksha. Purvapaksha is being reiterated here. What did the Purvapakshi say? Yatha, just as Vartamana janmarambhakani karmani natshiyante. So you are now talking about the prarabdha karma. So all this, the three types of karma are over. Now we are talking about prarabdha karma. The Purvapakshi has come to prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma, you know. Prarabdha means that karma which has started giving results. So by virtue of that karma, some karma, he has taken this birth. And then in this, by virtue of that karma, he has gone to a guru. He has gone to some, he has done some shavana, manana, nididhyasana. And then he has attained jnanam and all that. So here, vartamana janmarambhakani karmani natshiyante phaladanaya pravruttanyeva satyapi jnane. Satyapi jnane means jnane sati api. So even if jnana is there, these karmas will continue to give result. It has started giving result. So a jnani also will undergo some type of displeasure, some type of unhappiness. He may not feel that unhappiness. From the point of view of others, he will be having all that. From the point of view of all others, he will be seeing some personal problems and all these things may be there. So all those things, phaladanaya pravruttanyeva, that is, they are continuing to give result. Phaladanaya pravruttanyeva, that is, they are continuing to give result. Satyapi jnane. That means, jnane sati api, in spite of jnanam, in spite of the fact that he is a jnani, there are these prarabdha karmas which are giving result to him. So that is the point. You follow that?
Yes, sir.
In spite of the fact that the person is a jnani, the prarabdha karma is continuing to give result. So satyapi jnane, tatha, anarabdha phalanam api karmanam chayahana yuktaha. Likewise, just as you are admitting that this arabdha, prarabdha karma is not going to end without giving result. Similarly, the same rule you have to apply to all those other karmas also. So that is what he says. You apply the same rule to other karmas also. Tatha anarabdha phalanam api karmanam chayahana yuktaha. Those karmas which have not started giving results, they also, their chaya, their nullification, their cancellation is not proper. So that is what he says. Iti tadasat. कथम तेषां मुक्तेषुवत् प्रवृत्तफलत्वात् यथा पूर्वं लक्ष्यवेधाय मुक्तः इषुः धनुषः लक्ष्यवेधोत्तरकालं
लक्ष्य वेधोत्तर कालम
आरब्ध वेग क्षयात
आरब्ध
लक्ष्य लक्ष्योत्तर लक्ष्य वेधोत्तर कालम अपि
लक्ष्य वेधोत्तर कालम अपि
आरब्ध वेग क्षयात
आरब्ध वेग क्षयात
पतनेनैव निवर्तते
पतनेनैव निवर्तते
एवं शरीरारंभकं कर्म
एवं शरीरारंभकं कर्म
शरीर स्थिति प्रयोजने निमित्तेपि निवृत्तेपि निप्रयोजने निवृत्तेपि
शरीरस्थितिप्रयोजने निवृत्तेपि
आ संस्कार वेगक्षयात्
आ संस्कार वेगक्षयात्
पूर्ववत् वर्तते एव
पूर्ववत् वर्तते एव
सो नाउ यू आर गिविंग द एग्जांपल ऑफ एन एनालॉजी ऑफ एन आर्चर इन दोस डेज गन्स वर नॉट देयर सो आर्चरी सो यू हैव से cocked an arrow on that bow string, and then you have released that arrow, and then that arrow has gone, and then it has pierced through the target, and then it is still moving, and it will still move, it will pierce the target and still move, and then when the speed comes down, when the velocity comes down, it will fall down on the ground. So that is what we know. So likewise, you see the here this prarabdha karma is somewhat like that. Prarabdha karma is that it has produced a result, that is lakshya vedha. Lakshya vedha, lakshya means target, vedha means hitting the target. Lakshya vedha yatha purvam lakshya vedhaya, vedha means to hit it. Lakshya vedha means hitting a target. So it goes and then hits a target. Mukteshu vat, mukta ishu, mukta plus ishu, mukta ye, mukteshu. Mukta means released, mukta is released. Mukti is release and realization, that is a different sense. But here, mukta ishu, an arrow that has been released. Ishu means arrow. Ishu is arrow. Mukteshu means arrow which has been released. Mukteshu vat pravrutta phalatvat. So that activity is going on. Pravrutta phalam. That activity is going on. Yatha purvam lakshyavedhaya muktaha ishuhu dhanushaha. Muktaha ishuhu dhanusha means an arrow which has been released from the bow. Dhanushaha means from the bow. It is in Panchami Vibhakti. Dhanushaha muktaha ishuhu. An arrow which has been released from the bow. Like that. And why was it released? Lakshya vedhaya. In order to hit the target. So it has hit the target. It has pierced through that. And then still it goes some distance and then it falls. So likewise, having given some result, then when the speed comes down, that prarabdha karma will die down. So that is the point. That prarabdha karma is compared to an arrow which has been released from a bow. And then it is also compared to kulala chakra nyaya. This I told some earlier. Kulala chakra means a potter. He rotates the wheel. He rotates the wheel and prepares the say pot. It takes and gently takes out the pot. And then he doesn't bother to stop the wheel. So he simply takes it out and then he keeps it in a special place, say a proper place. So by that time it continues to rotate for some time, and then when the speed slowly, that momentum comes down, and then it comes to a halt. So it is like that. Mukteshu is one example. This kulala chakra, the potter's wheel, is another example for in order to describe the effect of this prarabdha karma. सो यथा पूर्वं लक्ष्यवेधोत्तरकालमपि मीन्स् ईवन् आफ्टर् हिटिङ्ग् दि टार्गेट् आरब्धवेगक्षयात् पतनेनैव निवर्तते आरब्धवेगक्षयात् बै रिडक्षन् आफ् स्पीड् आफ्टर् रिडक्षन् आफ् स्पीड् ओन्ली आफ्टर् रिडक्षन् आफ् स्पीड् ओन्ली पतनेन निवर्तते बै फालिङ्ग् इट् कम्स् डौन् अण्ड् इट् फाल्स् आन् द ग्रौण्ड् एवं लैक् वैस् शरीरारम्भकं कर्म So this karma which is responsible for this gentleman to take up this life, sharirarambhakam, take up this janma, this karma which is responsible for this gentleman to take up this birth, sharira sthiti prayojane nivruttepi, though it has given the intended result, that is sharira sthiti prayojane. That sthiti prayojana means, what is the sharira sthiti prayojana? What is the highest objective of human life? Moksha, isn't it? Though it has helped him in attaining that moksha, sharira sthiti prayojane nivruttepi, though it has been attained, then a samskara vega kshayat, that samskara vega, that speed is there, that speed has to come down. So avegakshayat means a means it is with that suffix, that prefix, it indicates till the time ajanubahu you say. Ajanubahu means say the shoulders which are extending up to knee level. That is, that was in olden days, probably I don't know why it was considered a very great quality in a person. Ajanubahu, they say. Very long, hands reaching up to the knees. maybe it may, but anyway, A means till that point. So that means till that point. So A Vega Kshayat means till that Vega, till that speed comes to a close, till that steadily declines, till that steadily comes down. Purvavad Vartate Eva, that is, it moves on till gradually the speed gets reduced. So that is what it is. Till the speed gradually gets reduced, the arrow goes on and then falls down. So similarly, this prarabdha karma is also like that. So prarabdha karma is compared to an arrow which has been released from above. And then what about anarabdha karmas? They are like an arrow which is just cocked on the bow but not released. You see, we have taken a bow. You have also put arrow on the bowstring and then you have just cocked it. Now you have not released. So you are at liberty to bring it, you take it out and then you have to take out the string also from the bow, isn't it? So that is what is going to say. So then, sayeva ishuhu,
sayeva ishuhu,
pravrutti nimitta anarabdha vegaha,
pravrutti nimitta anarabdha vegaha,
vegastu amuktaha dhanushi prayuktopi upasamhriyate
tatha anarabdha phalani karmani
swashreyasthanyeva jnanena nirbiji kriyante iti patitesmin vidvat sharire
nasa bhuyo bhijayate
iti yuktameva uktam iti siddham. Okay, so he is comparing to all other karmas, he is comparing to the arrows which have been cocked on that bow. There are so many arrows, there is a long quiver in that quiver. Quiver is the place where you keep all those arrows, tuniram we call it. So in that quiver there are so many arrows. So you take out one arrow after the other and then you are shooting. So one arrow has produced this particular life. So again there is another arrow which is readily cocked. But then because of jnana agni, all those things they get destroyed. So that is it. Saeva yushuhu means the same arrow. Saeva yushuhu, the same arrow. Pravrutti nimitta anarabdha vegaha. That is, it has not started giving the result. Pravrutti nimitta means that is the cause for some pravrutti. Pravrutti nimitta, the cause for action. There is no cause of action. So pravrutti nimitta anarabdha vega. That is, it has not been released. So such a thing, amuktaha dhanushi prayuktopi. Amuktaha means not released. Muktaha is released. Amuktaha not released. Dhanushi prayuktaha api. Prayuktaha means though it has been put on the bow. Though it has been cocked on the bow, prayuktaha, it is already there, it is kept ready to shoot, but he has not shot, he has not released. Prayuktaha api, upasamhriyate means withdraws. Upasamhriyate, tatha, likewise, anarabdha phalani karmani, all these karmas which have not started giving result. That is anarabdha phalani karmani, all the karmas which have not started giving result. Swashrayasthanyeva. They are in their ashraya, swa ashraya stha means something which is staying in its own place. That is what is that place? In the case of a human being, in the jiva only. Swashraya is jiva only, isn't it? In that jiva only, that baggage is there. In that jiva only, all the baggage of old karmas, that huge quiver of arrows, it is there. He is carrying it like a bundle of sticks. So like that, swashrayasthanyeva, all those arrows which are there in the, all those karmas which are there in the jiva only, jiva is their ashraya. Ashraya means that their shelter, their dwelling place, ashraya. अस्वाश्रयस्थान्येव ज्ञानेन निर्बीजीक्रियन्ते दे आर् गोयिङ्ग् टु बी निर्बीजीक्रिय निर्बीजीकरणं मीन्स् the seedless, now something like seedless mango, they are going to be nirbijikriyante, all those things, they are going to be like roasted seeds, they are going to be ineffective, they are going to be, they will be rendered ineffective like roasted seeds. Nirbijikriyante, nirbijikriya is that one. Nirbijikarnam is also a word which is also used in yoga Patanjali Darshana also, nirbijikarnam, there also the word comes. सो निर्बीजीक्रियन्ते इति देन् पतितेस्मिन् विद्वत् शरीरे वन्स् दिस् विद्वत् शरीर फाल्स् विद्वत् शरीर वि नो विद्वत् शरीर मीन्स् दि बाडी आफ् ए ज्ञानी द बाडी आफ् ए ज्ञानी वन्स् दिस् फाल्स् देन् वाट् हेपन्स् यस्टर्डे वि डिस्कस्ड् दि लिङ्ग शरीर डस् नाट् ट्रान्स्मैग्रेट् बिकास् दट् लिङ्ग शरीर ओन्ली वेन् द पोस्ट् ईस् देर् द पोस्ट् मेन् गोस् अण्ड् डेलिवर्स् वेन् द पोस्ट् ईस् नाट् देर् देर् इस् नो बडि नो वेर् टु गो सो इट् सो द पोस्टल् डिपार्ट्मेण्ट् वैण्ड्स् अप् सो संथिङ्ग् लैक् देट् सो दिस् लिङ्ग शरीर इट् वैण्ड्स् अप् इट्स् एक्सिस्टेन्स् द प्राणास् दे मर्ज् इन् दि वैटल् एयर्स् दि महा दि वायुस् and then the senses and the mind, they merge in the tanmatras. So that is what happens. So patitesmin vidvat sharire nasa bhuyah abhijayate, again he does not take birth. Iti yuktam eva vuktam, it is properly told, iti siddham. So all this discussion is about what happens after a person dies. So in fact this is a very very important matter in any religion, isn't it? Any religion has to postulate something about what happens after death. So this is actually in theology, it is called eschatology. There is a big word for that, eschatology, E-S-C-H-A-T-O-L-O-G-Y, eschatology. So in that eschatology, they say, for example, the Semitic religions, they say, the soul, they accept the soul, isn't it? The souls, all these souls, they will be just lingering on. The body is well preserved. The body is well preserved, and then all the souls, once they leave the body, they will all be lingering on in some place called purgatory. Purgatory is a place where all the souls, they undergo punishment and then they get purified. Then again on the day of judgment, there is a resurrection of all these people. There is a resurrection of all these people. So that is why all these the coffins are kept preserved. There is a resurrection. Angels, they come and then they blow some bugles. They blow the trumpets. Once the trumpet is blown, all the people they rise, all the dead people they rise. So that is their belief. That is their belief. But then of course, we want to account for the good and bad deeds. The Semitic religions, they don't account for the good and bad deeds of a person. They merely say, okay, on that judgment day, some angels come and then they blow the bugle and then blow the trumpet. So then all the dead people they arise. So that resurrection of all the dead. So that is their siddhanta, that is their postulation, whereas we account for the karma. So it is again a belief, it is a question of belief. So one belief, the clash of all the religions is somebody trying to impose one's belief on somebody else's belief. Ultimately that is the picture. So whereas we have got a more logical way of postulation. This is what we have to realize. It is not a simple belief. Proclaimed by somebody, there is a great discussion, there is a great logic which is behind this, the whole karma doctrine. Otherwise you can't account for the inequality in the world, account why one man is rich, another man is poor, all this inequality. Otherwise you will be attributing some partiality to God. So that Vaishamya Nairgrunya you will be attributing to God. So anyway, this happens to be a very very important discussion in olden days. So here the bhashyam for this shloka is over. Then the next, there is a slight shift in the subject. Shift in the subject means from here, the next few shlokas, they talk about how that realization, how is it attained. Different people are in different levels of sadhana. So different people in different levels, they adopt different practices, they adopt different methods in order to realize that, Brahman. So that they are being described here. Then, Atra Atma Darshane, Upaya Vikalpaha, Ime Dhyanadaya Uchyante. So the shift of the subject is regarding Atma Darshane, Upaya Vikalpaha. Different upayas are there. depending on the level at which a person is. Depending on the level, somebody is at a beginning level. So this beginning level, this man starts a karma yoga. At a slightly higher level, he goes to shravana manana. A slightly more highest level, he is in that state of nididhyasana. So that is what is being described. So vikalpa means alternative. Upaya vikalpa. Upaya means a means or strategy. Vikalpa. Vikalpa means say alternatives. So ime dhyanadayah, dhyana etc. These are the vikalpas. They are different steps which are adopted by different stages, which are adopted by different levels of people. So let us read the shloka. Dhyanenatmani pasyanti.
Dhyanenatmani pasyanti.
Kechidatmanamatmana.
Kechidatmanamatmana.
Anyesankhyena
yogena. Anyesankhyena
yogena. Karma yogena chapare.
Karma yogena chapare.
So here, dhyanena, the first line talks about one. The first line talks about one type of people. Dhyanena atmani pasyanti kechit atmanam atmana. So this word atma is used several times. So kechit means some people. Some people atmani atmanam atmana pasyanti. Atmani, in one's own self, in one's own buddhi. Where is atma realized? Atma is realized in one's own buddhi only. We know that manasaiva anudrashtavyam. Manasaiva, you see, manayeva manushyanam karanam bandhamokshayoho. The mind is the only thing which is available for a human being. For thinking, for either for bondage or for liberation, the mind is the only tool you have got. Then manasaiva anudrashtavyam. So the mind is the only tool through which you have that vision anudrashtavyam, that drushti or darshanam or vision of that Brahman is possible only through the mind. So here, atmani means buddhau, in the buddhi, in one's own buddhi. Then atmanam means pratyagatmanam, that pratyagatma, that supreme self, that innermost self is realized by what? Atmana eva, by buddhi only. By buddhi only means by what type of buddhi? Shastrena samskrutena buddhya. Shastrena samskrutena antahkaranena. So that antahkarana is something which has been refined by the study of shastra. So that type of atma. Atmana means samskrutena manasa. So somebody who has learned Sanskrit, samskrutena manasa means somebody whose mind has been purified. Samskara, samskrutena manasa, shravana manana adina samskrutena manasa. So by that buddhi, atmanam, pratyagatmanam, that is one's own self, atmane in the buddhi is realized. So that is what some people do. So this is the highest level. The highest level means that nididhyasana level, where he has passed through all this karma yoga and shravana manana etc. And then he is in that nididhyasana, brahmakara vritti. We talk of brahmakara vritti etc. So he is in that level. Then anye sankhyena yogena. We know about this sankhya yoga. Sankhya yoga is viveka. Sankhya samyak khyayate atma tattvam anena iti sankhyam. That is what we saw in second chapter. Atma tattvam is known only by viveka, only by proper discrimination. To start with Nityanitya Vastu Viveka, then getting into Atma 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 Anatma Viveka, and then in that Atma Anatma Viveka, prior to that you have to have a lot of self-discipline and all that. After that self-discipline, this Viveka starts, then Shravana, Manana, all this whole thing goes on. So that is what is Sankhya. So at an intellectual level, he is pursuing and then he is trying to understand. So that is Sankhya Yoga. Anye Sankhyena Yogena. By that yoga, they are trying to attain this Atman. Then karma yogena cha apare. Apare means some others. Some others. Karma yogena cha. By means of this karma yoga. Karma yoga directly does not lead to Atma darshana, we know. We have to always remember, Shankaracharya also is going to say that point. So karma yoga directly does not lead to Atma darshana. It purifies the mind. Karma yoga prepares the mind for that Atma darshana. After the mind is well prepared, after the mind is well samskrutam, that is well refined, then the mind has to go to the Shrotriya Brahmanishta, and then do that Shravana Manana etc., and then it has to attain that Brahman. So that is the point. So karma yogena cha apare. So there are three levels which are told in this mantra, in this shloka. The first line is referring to uttamadhikari, a person who has reached the highest level of sadhana. Then the anye sankhyena yogena is madhyamadhikari. Then the last one, karma yogena mandadhikari, for the ordinary man. So it is told like that. Is the shloka clear?
Yes.
Okay, then let us read the bhashyam. Dhyanena iti.
Dhyanena iti.
Dhyanam nama.
Dhyanam nama.
Shabdadibhyo visayebhyaha.
Shabdadibhyo visayebhyaha.
Shrotradini karanani.
Shrotradini karanani.
Manasi upasamhrutya.
Manasi upasamhrutya.
Manasya pratyak chetaitari.
Manasya pratyak chetaitari.
Ekagrataya yat chintanam tad dhyanam. Okay, Shrotra Dhyanam. Shankaracharya, quite often he has defined this word Dhyanam. Dhyanam nama, Shabdadibhyaha Vishayebhyaha. So from all these Vishayas, Vishayas means the external objects. What are they? Shabdas, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, different types of attractions which are there. Shrotradini Karanani. All these karana, all these indriyani, hayana, who isn't, they are like horses which jump around. So all these horses have been very properly reined in, very properly controlled. And then karanani, manasi upasamhrutya, having withdrawn into the mind, then mind also has to be withdrawn. This mind again, you withdraw the indriyas, it doesn't, the mind keeps on wandering. So the mind also has to be withdrawn. So manasya pratyakcheta itari. The mind also has to be withdrawn and kept in that pratyak chetaita. Chetaita means the thing which enlivens. Chetaita, chetanam, you know, chetanam means chaitanyam consciousness. Chetaita means one who enlivens, one who illumines it, enlivens it. So that is chetaita. One who makes it alive is chetaita. So pratyak chetaita, that is what we call pratyagatma. So this mind also has to be kept inside, in that pratyagatma, then ekagrataya yachintanam. So with one-pointed thinking about one-pointed awareness, let us say, one-pointed awareness that one is not different from Brahman. So attaining that Brahmakara vritti, so that is what is referred to here. Because this is, why I am saying this Brahmakara vritti, because all the commentators, subsequent commentators, Anandagiri, Nilakantha, Madhusudana Saraswati, all these people have said this dhyanam refers to nididhyasanam, which is of the highest level. For example, I will read out Madhusudana Vyakhya. Ihahi chaturvidha janaha kechid uttamaha kechid madhyamaha kechid mandaha kechid mandataraha iti. So he is referring to uttama, madhya, manda, and then mandatara. Mandatara is going to, we will see in the next shloka. Then dhyanena vijatiya pratyayantara pratyaya antari anantaritena antaritena sajatiya pratyaya pravahena, then shravana manana phalabhutena atma chintanena nididhyasana shabdoditena nididhyasana. He is saying that, so after you pass that stages of shravana manana, and then this nididhyasana, which has resulted as a result of shravana and manana, so that is what is referred to here. So that is what Anandagiri says, that is what other people also have said. So on the face of it, when you read this shloka, you will just see three types. But then what are those three types? There are three different degrees. So that is what is explained by the commentators. So dhyanam nama, okay, we have read that. Tat dhyanam. Then tatha, dhyayativa bakaha.
Dhyayativa bakaha.
Dhyayativa prithivi.
Dhyayativa prithivi.
Dhyayantiva parvataha.
Iti
upamopadanat tairadharavat santataha avichinna pratyayaha dhyanam. So this tairadhara example we have seen in other places also. Tairadharavat tulya pratyaya santatihi asankirnacha atat pratyayehi. That definition, it comes in Taittiriya Upanishad. Taittiriya Upanishad. So like that, we have seen that in some other places. Then, tatha, dhyayativa bakaha. This baka is a crane, which you find in ponds. Cranes which you find in ponds. The crane, what does it do? It stands on one leg and then it looks as though it is a great a fellow who is doing meditation. So its meditation is of course on the fish. So it is just waiting just to see whether a fish comes near, and then tuck, it catches that fish. So dhyayati eva bakah, as though that the crane, it is looking as though the crane is dhyayati, that is, it is meditating. Then just to give an example, Shankaracharya is saying dhyayati eva bakah, that dhyaya, that meditation, to give an example he is saying that. Then dhyayati eva prithivi. Prithivi, sometimes in the dead of the night, particularly if you stay in a forest area, suppose you stay in a rural place, suppose totally rural place where there are no sounds of which you normally find in an urban area. So it looks as though the prithivi, the whole earth, is just meditating. It will be so silent, it is so silent, so serene, and then everywhere if you just sit around and then see in the jungle, it looks as though the prithivi is totally silent and meditating. So that is it, dhyayativa prithivi. Then dhyayantiva parvataha. Similarly, you have to visualize a forest surrounding. You have to visualize some place where you have done some trekking. And then in the where you have trekked and then made a night halt in that place, there if you see the mountains around you, they look as though they are so silent, they look as though they are meditating. So dhyayantiva parvataha. Like that, dhyayantiva parvataha, ity upamopadanat. Upamopadanat means upama upadanam. Upadanam means taking that, using that example. Upamopadanat means upamayaha upadanat. Because of such upamas, not only Shankaracharya, many people have given such examples, so that is why he is saying upamopadanat. Because of such famous analogies which are given, we have to deduce that Tailadharavat santataha, a continuous flow of ideas, a continuous flow of similar ideas. Tailadharavat, Tailadhara, you know, they're like a stream of that long line of oil. Then Tailadharavat, avichinna pratyayaha, there is no vichitti. If you pour oil, if you pour water, the water, it breaks into drops. Whereas Tailadhara, it does not break. Avichinna pratyayaha, all this pratyaya, this jnana santati, this jnana pravaha, so that stream of consciousness, as we call it, that stream of consciousness has to be continuous. So that is what is called dhyana. So avichinna pratyayaha dhyanam, avichinna pratyaya, stream of consciousness not disturbed by dissimilar thoughts, stream of similar thoughts. So that is again we have to see, stream of similar thoughts undisturbed by dissimilar thoughts. Then dhyanam,
tena dhyanena
atmani buddhau
pashyanti atmanam pratyakchetanam
atmana dhyana samskrutena antahkaranena kechit yoginaha. So this kechit refers to yoginaha, the top level people. What do they do? Tena dhyanena, by means of that dhyana, atmani pashyanti. Atmani means buddhau, in that intellect, in the buddhi only, they have darshan of that, they have vision of that, they have understanding. Vision means that suddenly some sort of some broad, big lightning, huge light and etc. It is not that sort of vision, this understanding. So then, atmani buddhau, pashyanti atmanam pratyakchetanam. Pratyakchetanam is that inner self which is enlivening you, that inner self which is motivating you. Dhiyo yona prachodayat, so that is what it is, dhiyo yona prachodayat, that supreme thing which is motivating my dhi means buddhi vritti, all these dhiyo yona dhiyah prachodayat. So that tat savitur varenyam bhargah, that varenyam bhargah savituhu dhiyah yahanah prachodayat. So that is what is the pratyakchetayita. So pratyagatmanam pratyakchetanam. Then atmana means by means of the mind. What type of mind? Dhyana samskrutena antahkaranena. This is again purified. Samskrutam means purified. Samskrutena antahkaranena. Kechid yoginaha pashyanti. Okay. Then anye sankhyena yogena. Sankhyam nama.
Ime sattva rajastamamsi gunaha.
Maya drushyaha.
मया दृश्यः
अहं तेभ्यः अन्यः
अहं तेभ्यः अन्यः
तद्व्यापारसाक्षीभूतः नित्यः गुणविलक्षणः आत्मा इति चिन्तनम् एष साङ्ख्यः साङ्ख्यो योगः तेन पश्यन्ति आत्मानम् आत्मना इति वर्तते सो आत्मानम् आत्मना दट् इस् अप्लैड् टु आल् अदर् थिङ्ग्स् आल्सो आत्मानम् आत्मना दिस् प्रत्येगात्मा इस् सीन् बै दट् बुद्धि वाट् दिस् आत्मानम् आत्मना इस् अप्लैड् टु दिस् थिङ्ग् आल्सो सो अन्ये अदर्स् साङ्ख्येन योगेन बै मीन्स् आफ् साङ्ख्ययोग वाट् इस् साङ्ख्य ही इस् डिफैनिङ्ग् इमे सत्वरजस्तमांसि गुणाः सो दिस् मेन् ही इस् बै विवेक ही इस् ऐडेण्टिफैङ्ग् सो वेन् ही इस् एङ्ग्रि ही इस् वाचिङ्ग् इस् एङ्गर् वेन् ही इस् हेपी ही इस् वाचिङ्ग् इस् हेपिनेस् सो दीस् आर् सत्वरजस्तमो गुणाः ही इस् वाचिङ्ग् इस् सत्वरजस्तमो गुणाः देन् ही इस् वाचिङ्ग् दि एफेक्ट्स् द विकारास् आफ् दोस् सत्वरजस्तमो गुणाः द विकार आफ् दोस् गुणास् आर् द सेम् सुख दुःख मोह So this man, he is not getting involved in that, whereas he is watching. So he practices that watching. So that is one thing. All these things are gunaha. Maya drushyaha. I am not that. All these things are drushyas. They are all objects for me. I am objectifying them. So he is in that state. Then aham tebhyaha anyaha. I am distinct from that. I am something which is vilakshana, something different from that, something distinct from that. Then tadvyapara sakshibhutaha. I am a sakshi, I am a witness to all these things. I am of the nature of pure consciousness. So I am a witness to all these things. So all these things, so this is a continuous practice which goes on. This continuous abhyasa which goes on. Then what am I? Nityaha gunavilakshanaha atma iti chintanam. Nityaha. I am that eternal consciousness. Guna vilakshanaha, I am totally distinct from these gunas which are forever changing. Gunas, they keep on changing. They manifest in different types of vikaras. So I am that atma, this unchanging atma. Iti chintana meva. So thinking, the thinking of this type, an understanding of that type is sankhya. Sankhya yoga. And tena pasyanti atmanam atmana. By means of such thing, the other people slowly go to the level of Nididhyasana and then they will slowly realize that Atma. Then Karma Yogena Ishwararpana Buddhya Anushthiyamanam Ghatana Rupam Yogarthatvat Yoga Uchyate So Karma Yogena Karma Yoga directly does not lead to Jnanam. So that is what he says. Karma Yogena, Karma Eva Yoga. Why is Karma called Yoga? Because Ishwararpana Buddhya Anushthiyamanam. So when you are performing Karma with the notion of that Ishwararpana Buddhi as an offering to that Samashti, as your duty, as an order from the Lord, then Ghatana Rupam means it facilitates. Ghatana, you know. Ghataka, you say. Aghatana ghatana samartha yuse. So that is somebody who is capable of effecting things which are very, very difficult to say attain. So aghatana ghatana, so you, when you describe somebody as a very, very competent man, you say, oh, he is a great competent man. Ghatana ghatana samartha. So you say. So like that ghatana rupam, that which facilitates. Facilitates for what? Facilitates atma jnana. ईश्वरार्पण बुद्धिया अनुष्ठीयमानं घटना रूपं योगार्थत्वात् बिकॉज इट हेल्प्स इन दिस योग योगा मीन्स दिस यूनियन ऑफ दिस थिंग विद दैट परमात्मा सो योगार्थत्वात् बिकॉज इट फैसिलिटेट्स दैट यूनियन देन योग इति उच्यते दैट इज बाय से फिगरेटिवली इट इज कॉल्ड योग बिकॉज इट फैसिलिटेट्स दिस यूनियन So this Ishwararpana Buddhya Kritam Karma, this karma is called yoga figuratively because it facilitates in that union. Uchyate. There is only one last line, I think we can read this. Gunataha Tena Sattvashuddhi Jnanotpatti Dvarena Cha Apare. Uchyate Gunataha. My book, it has wrongly put a full stop here. Uchyate Gunataha. Gunataha means... figuratively. Only figuratively you are calling it yoga. Then tena sattvashuddhi jnanotpatti dvarena cha. Apare. So Shankaracharya is very clearly pointing out that apare, others, sattvashuddhi, this karma yoga is leading to sattvashuddhi and that is leading to jnanotpatti. So this process we have discussed earlier several times. So we will stop here. We will continue in the next class. ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः